Hello everybody, welcome to Word Chart.
Today is the second day of our class and we were doing an Old Man at the Bridge written by Ernest Hemingway. Before we move into the chapter, we can see the picture of Ernest Hemingway. This is very important that we know the poet or the author whose work we are studying. So I have put up a picture of Ernest Hemingway so that we know this writer. Okay, so let's move into the next part of the chapter now. In the last class, we have seen that the old man and the narrator were talking about something. And what was that? The narrator was asking the old man about his animals. Now, he goes on asking, what animals were they? Now, the narrator asks him, what were the animals that you were looking or you were taking care of? There were three animals altogether. How many animals were there? Three animals, he explained. What were the animals? This is a very important part. Okay, you have to remember, questions will come from this part of the chapter. What were the animals? There were two goats, a cat, and then there were four pairs of pigeons. So there were three types of animals. There were goats, there was a cat, there were four pairs of pigeons. And you had to leave them, I asked. So you had to leave your animals and come. Okay, why he had to come? Because of the artillery attack. What do you mean by artillery? I have given a picture over here. See, this is the artillery, the heavy gun that you carry during war. That is an artillery. So there was a threat and people knew that there was going to be an artillery attack by the fascists. So they were removed from their villages. Okay, that is why the old man had to leave San Carlo and come to this pontoon bridge to cross the bridge and go to safety. The captain told me to go because of the artillery. The captain who was taking care of the villagers, he had ordered the old man to leave his village immediately and go to safety. Why? Because there was a chance of an artillery attack on their village. Now we'll move on to the next part. And you have no family. So you say that you are not taking care of your family. You had no family. Just you were there to take care of your animals, I asked. Watching the far end of the bridge where a last few carts were hurrying down the slope on the bank. So again, I'll draw the bridge for you. So this side, people were no more there. At the other side also, the risk-free zone, that side also, there were no carts now. All of the people have almost gone there, gone to the directions. Some people have gone this way, some people have gone the other way. No, he said, only the animals, I stated. So I had no family, I was only taking care of my animals. The cat, of course, will be all right. Now we will come into detail. This is an important part. There are some symbols attached to these animals. The cat, first the cat. The cat is a symbol of independence. Independence means this is a type of a creature who can take care of itself. Okay, he's not going to be in danger. He will not put itself into danger. It will find a safe place for itself. It can survive on its own. So a cat is a symbol of independence. A cat can look out for itself, but I cannot think what will become of the others. What will become of the others means the old man does not know that what will happen to the other creatures. What were the other creatures? The goats and the dove. What politics have you? Now the narrator is asking that you are in which side? We ask, no, which political party do you support, like that. What politics, are you supporting the Spanish loyalists or are you supporting the fascists? Which side are you? So he says, I am without politics. This is a very important line. You can quote it whenever you are writing an answer. I am without politics. That is, I am supporting none. I was a very innocent man doing nothing, just taking care of my animals. I was not involved into these political issues, he said. I am 76, important part, 76 years old. 12 kilometers he has walked all the way from his village to this part of the bridge. And I think I can go no further. So he's very tired. He cannot walk any further. So he just comes and sits at the risky side of the bridge and cannot cross it. He cannot walk any further and therefore he cannot go to safety. So what is the impending situation? That this man is surely going to sit here and will surely die because of the fascists' attack. This is not a good place to stop. Now the narrator goes on saying that you need to go to safety. This is not a place that where you can stop because soon the people will come and harm you. If you can make it, there are trucks up the road where it forks for Tortosa. So in this part of the bridge, when you have crossed the bridge, you can go to the different directions. You can go to Tortosa, and there is the land forks, that is the land divides into separate sides. So you can take a truck and go to Tortosa, or you can go to Barcelona. I will wait a while, he said, and then I will go. So he says that for some more time, I will wait over here, and then maybe I will go to the other side. And where do the trucks go? So where, when I reach the other side of the bridge, where will the trucks take me? The trucks go to Barcelona. Barcelona is another city in Spain. I know no one in that direction. So even if I go to the other side, even if I go to Barcelona, even if I go to Tortosa, I know nobody over there. So it is of no meaning for me to go to that place, he said. But thank you very much. Thank you again very much. He looked at me very blankly and tiredly, then said, having to share his worry with some, "The cat will be all right." Now he is satisfied that, okay, fine, the cat is an independent animal and it will go to safety. Then there is no need to be unquiet, that means worried about a cat. But the others, now others, what are the other animals? Why, they will probably come through it all right. The narrator tries to pacify this man, tries to calm this man by saying that, okay, your animals will be okay. They will find their way. Why not? I said, watching the far bank where now there were no carts. Now on the other side of the bridge, all the people have gone their own way. There was nobody there. So the old man was left alone with the narrator at complete risk. But what will they do under the artillery attack when I was told to leave because of the artillery? Because of the artillery, the human beings were removed from there. The human beings, being superior creatures, they were removed from the place. So obviously the animals will be at risk. Obviously the animals will die. Did you leave the dove cage unlocked? Did you leave the cage unlocked so that the pigeons can fly? Yes. Then they will fly. Obviously then the doves will not sit over there in harm. In so much risk, they will obviously fly away. Now, yes, certainly they will fly. Now, this is another important thing. What is the pigeon symbol of? Pigeons represent peace and harmony, which means that pigeons are quite like these refugees who have decided to run away for safety. They have decided to leave their land to go to a safer place. So these refugees are symbols. The pigeons are a symbol to these refugees. They symbolize the refugees who decide to run away in times of danger because they love peace and harmony. They don't want a lot of problems. That is why they will just run away. But the others, it is better not to think about the others. This is an important line. It is better not to think about the others. It is better not to think about the goat because the goat is surely going to die. Goat is quite like home. Goat is like the old man. See, this is an important part. The goat is a sacrificial animal that is sacrificed in times of danger, in times of risk, and is quite like the old man who is sacrificed in times of war. They are innocent, yet they become helpless victims of war. They are obviously innocent. They were not involved in politics. They were not involved in anything. They were just so innocent, helpless beings, but they are sacrificed during war. So what does this story tell you? The story tells us that war is futile. There is no need of war. War is worthless. It is harming people. It only destroys people. There is no positive effect of war. So the whole story talks about the negative impacts, the destruction, the pointlessness of war. That is important. If you are rested, I would go, I urged. Get up and try to walk now. Now the narrator goes on telling him, please get up. Please try to walk. Thank you, he said, and got to his feet, swayed from side to side, and then sat down backwards in the dust. Now, he could not walk. Why did he not want to move from there? Because he was tired, because he had walked 12 kilometers from San Carlos. Number two, he did not want to go to the other side. He has given up, isn't it? Because he was taking care of his animals. He could not leave his animals and go to safety. He was already dead. When he had left his animals, his loved ones, he was already feeling that he was dead. He found no reason to go to Barcelona or Tortosa. There was nobody for him. Okay. So I was taking care of animals, he said dully, but no longer to me. I was only taking care of animals. He just goes on saying on his own that, why am I facing such problems? I have not done anything to anybody. Why am I thrown away from my own home? Why am I separated from my loved ones? All this shows what? The futility of war, the negative impacts of war. There was nothing to do about him. It was Easter Sunday, another symbol. Easter Sunday is a day when Christ rose from the dead. Christ died, and after 3 days, there was his resurrection. After he was crucified, 3 days after that, he came back to life. Okay, so that day is Easter Sunday. So this is a symbol of what? This is a symbol of hope, isn't it? This is a symbol of life, rebirth, positivity. But over here, it is an irony, isn't it? That on an Easter Sunday, when Christ returned, when there was a rebirth of hope and positivity, at that particular day, this old man, this helpless, this innocent old man is going to lose his life. He has lost all hope. He does not want to survive anymore. He does not want to cross the bridge to safety because he has lost all hope. So it is ironical that on an Easter Sunday, this old man is so helpless and is going to die. Now, next. And the fascists are this already we have discussed, political leaders who support fascism. They do not support any opposition. They do not accept any other ideas or logic. Now, it was a grey overcast day. This is also another symbol. Grey is a symbol of hopelessness, of negativity. Now, it was a grey overcast day and a low ceiling when we don't have any hope for anything. It is that particular symbol. That's the fact that cats know how to look after themselves was all the good luck the old man would ever have. Now, the old man is only satisfied with this, that at least the cats will move to safety. At least the doves will fly. But he is going to be sacrificed just like the goat without any crime being committed. Okay. Now we will move to the theme, the most important theme. This is very, very important. You can double tick this point. Futility of war. What is futility? Futility means negative impacts of war. Hemingway depicts the pointlessness and futility of war. There is no need of war. Why do we need death and destruction? It causes death and destruction of people and poverty and property. Man acts inhumanly. Man acts inhumanly against whom? Against his own race, isn't it? Man kills man. That is very pointless. That is very useless. There is nothing constructive in it. The old man is a symbol of the innocent civilians. There are many civilians who lose their lives because of war. So that is a symbol. The old man is a symbol of all of them. The old man says he is without politics, yet he has to sacrifice his dear animals and also himself to war. He has done no harm to anybody. Still, he is being sacrificed. So this is not right, isn't it? Somebody who has not committed a crime, somebody who has not done anything, and he is losing his life. This is not right. And in a war, so many people like that often dies. As it sits near the Ebro River, his impending death, his approaching death is very much prominent, that he is soon going to die. We all know that when he sits at this side of the bridge, soon there will be an artillery attack, there will be guns fired. So now what will happen to the old man? Obviously, he is going to die. Let's move to the next part, the symbols. This is the bridge. This is not the pontoon bridge, but this is just a picture of the bridge. Why have I drawn this? Why have I pasted this picture over here? To show that this side of the bridge, one side and the other side. Now, bridge is a symbol of connecting something. There are two sides of the bridge and the bridge connects the two sides. Maybe this bridge is a symbol of life. Isn't it? And the both sides, this side, one side and the other side. Maybe this is life and this is death. And this part in the middle, in the center, while we are crossing the bridge, that is the life. So a bridge is a symbol of life that connects two ends, life and death. First symbol. Next, it marks the need to give up war. When we talk about a bridge, it is obviously connecting something. We should connect to people, connect to more people. We should not divide ourselves into fragments, isn't it? Rabindranath Tagore has said, where the mind is without fear, we should not divide our minds into fragments. We should free ourselves of all these boundaries. We should think that the person living in America, the person living in Bangladesh, Pakistan, everybody is quite like us. We are all human beings. So we should build trust, faith, love, humanity. Most important, humanity. We should build up humanity so that there is no need of war, so that we can connect like a bridge connects the two sides. Okay. Next, we will move to the last one, which is irony. What is an irony? This is already discussed in this part only. Easter Sunday, we have already said Easter Sunday marks the day when Christ returned 3 days after his crucifixion. So Easter is a symbol which of welcoming life, renewal, change, positivity. But in the same day, we see the old man is waiting for his inevitable death. He's surely going to die. So it is ironical that on this particular day, the man, an innocent man, loses his life. Okay, so that is all from this chapter. We have discussed all the symbols, all the ideas, and all the themes that is associated with the story. And there is nothing more to talk about it. We will move on to the questions soon in the next class. Thank you so much, children. If you have liked the video, please like and subscribe. Thank you.